Hi, this is Marianne Susi from healingpetloss.com. In this video, I will continue on the topic of dealing with guilt after pet loss. In my last video, how to ease the guilt after pet loss, I shared a simple technique that you can use. And in this video, I'm going to do something different. I'm going to read a chapter from my book, From Grief to Gratitude After Pet Loss, Healing Messages and Guidance from Pets in the Afterlife. I'm going to read chapter 9 on dealing with guilt after pet loss. When you have lost a beloved animal companion, one of the most challenging feelings you can experience is a feeling of guilt. It is also a very common feeling after pet loss. My favorite way to get healing and advice is to turn to my helping spirit in a meditation or a sacred spirit journey. The following is what happened when I asked for advice on dealing with guilt after pet loss. I prepared to connect with my spirit helpers, and I then experienced myself standing on the beach at the water's edge. I feel the waves gently touching my feet and moving away. Grief is like that too, my spirit guide says, and continues. Grief is like the waves, it comes and goes. As you learn to pay attention and allow your grief to be there, you will notice that grief, and in many cases, the guilt, can actually be a portal or opening into gratitude and forgiveness, into remembering and being the love that you shared, the love that you still share, and eventually are. Make use of the times where grief and guilt wash in over you. Those times are, in fact, a gift, an opportunity for you to go deeper within yourself and discover the place where you experience the continued presence and love of your beloved animal friend. And then I ask him, how specifically can people do that? And then he continues, the very best way to honor your pet and move from guilt to forgiveness, peace, and love is to learn from your pet. Use what you have been through as a learning experience. Practice doing so without judging or blaming yourself or others for that matter. First, what special gifts or teaching did your pet have for you? From the life you shared with them, what was their biggest teaching to you? How can you implement that in your life now, in their honor? Secondly, if you look at the circumstances leading up to or surrounding your pet's death, what can you learn from that? Is there something you can do differently in the future? This part may be easier to go through if you do it with someone who understands and supports you. Always return to a place of no blame and to a place of learning. That is how you can best honor your pet. Imagine your pet watching you from the afterlife and remember the unconditional love they always showed you. You still have access to that love. And you have seen yourself that it is eternal. Don't cut yourself off from the love your pet still has for you, the love that connects you, the love that you are. And then an action step for you. Take out a notebook or journal and note down what your pet's biggest teaching to you was and contemplate how you can get more of or implement that in your daily life. For example, if your pet's greatest gift was joy, how can you now bring more joy into your life? That was chapter 9 from my book, From Grief to Gratitude After Pet Loss, and the book is available on Amazon. And if you are looking for more pet loss support and also from with messages from pets in the afterlife, You can listen to the Healing Pet Loss podcast in iTunes. Blessings.